Hello.
Leon.
Hey, you guys.
Turn whatever down back there, would you?
Huh? Oh, sorry about that.
All right.
Okay. You guys, I had somewhat of a, like, a little thing going on with my friend.
You digging the underwear out of your ass while you're talking to us?
No, I'm just going into this little corner of my room so no one in the house will hear me.
I see.
6 months ago, me and my friend were on sort of like a campy trip, sort of semi-camping.
Camping. Oh.
That's it.
Yeah, and he got to drinking some tequila and some other, you know, like Irish whiskey or something.
Listen, I when I'm in charge, I will no longer let Americans refer to it as camping trips. I will call them raping trips.
Oh yeah,
it'll be like we're raping out. It'll be a rape fire. It'll be a rape portable stove. A raping stove, we'll call it raping. You know, it's just Cub Scouts are going a weekend raping trip.
And those cars in the back of pickup trucks will be rapers?
They'll be rapers. That's right. They'll no longer be campers. The term happy campers will be replaced by happy rapers. Every time people pitch a tent somewhere on some dirt, there is sex that is going to happen. I'm telling you, if I went camping with my neighbor's dog and my grandmother, I'd come back and we'll have had sex with both of them. Absolutely. Absolutely.
Do you think raping might be too strong a word because it's not usually forceable?
No, I know, but it's
humping?
It's sex that you wouldn't have had otherwise.
Yeah. It's got to be a better
even
word.
Even two
for that.
Guys go out. I don't know, camping,
vamping,
raping,
humping.
That sounds good to me.
All right.
So, happy rapers and the raping trip. And what other camp can I work in? Rape counselors.
Rape grounds?
Oh, wait a minute. Yeah, raping grounds.
Cabin could be a raping.
Well, no, yeah. No, cabin can't be replaced, Anderson. That cabin is where rapers go.
Rape grounds.
Rape grounds.
Rape.
KOA rape grounds?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, like I enjoy the Yosemite rape grounds because they have barbecues and community bathrooms.
Or is raping outdoors?
Oh, yeah.
Raping out under the stars?
Hello?
Leon?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was totally consensual.
I know. It's funny.
That's why I said the raping is not the right word. Yeah.
Yeah.
Anytime guys go at it, I look at it as rape. That's just the way I choose to look at it.
Yeah, well, I instigated it, so I'm the raper.
Doesn't matter. When I'm in charge, even if a gay couple who's been together for 35 years has a sexual encounter, it will be considered by the government as rape.
Right. Yeah. And
thank you.
We were out on the reservoir.
Yeah.
And it was in the back of his trailer hitch, and I don't know, he just started touching on me and I started touching on him and it happened.
Yeah, I see.
But, okay, 6 months later, to the present, I'm masturbating about guys daily.
Yeah.
And after I'm finished, after I'm finished, I feel like I want to kill myself afterwards.
Yeah.
Why?
I don't know, it's just this wave of guilt goes over my mind.
And who is it you're being judged by?
By myself.
And why are you judging?
Because I don't know. It's something biological in me that just says, after you're done fantasizing about this thing, then you're gonna hate yourself for it afterwards.
Are you religious?
No, I'm not.
So it's an important part.
I'm atheist.
Oh, what do you care then?
No, it's nothing religious. It's just I don't know. It's my guilty consciousness.
Are your parents religious?
No, my parents are separated.
But it's an important part of the experience.
Yeah.
My parents aren't religious. They're separated.
No. What? Because it's a religious experience.
No. Do you see how it's an important part of the experience for you to include guilt in the whole deal here?
Because of society?
No, it's that you don't allow... I think that's the only way you allow yourself even to have these thoughts is that, okay, if I feel enough guilt, it'll maybe expunge these thoughts or make me feel okay as a person if I feel bad about myself for what feelings I have.
Right.
Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
These are your feelings. These are your true feelings. They're fine. They're nothing to feel guilty about.
No, they're not my feelings, though.
But you need to feel guilty about them. That's the point. And that's in order to have them, you have to be sort of punished in order to have those
All
feelings.
Right. Leon.
That's not right.
Yeah. Listen to me. Maybe you're gay. Fine. That's all right. Look at all the guys you want. Masturbate to all the guys you want. Have all the boyfriends you want. It's okay. There's plenty of gay men out there.
I have a confession to make, though.
No.
To you guys.
Yeah, I don't want to hear it.
I didn't want to hear it. Oh, now I got to hear it.
It's going to be a bogus call.
I know.
I have to tell you something. It's really important or it's going to nag me for the rest of my life.
This is a bogus call, blah, blah, blah.
Let him say it. Go ahead. I believe him. Go ahead.
Look, okay. For the past 2 years, I've been calling in, right?
Yeah.
I've called in at least 12 times.
Yeah.
And I have a tape deck up here, and I record each and every one of them. I've gone as Steven Andrew,
what?
See, that's why he's bogus. Why, you know.
Oh, really? Don't want to talk to him?
He's going
to
tell you all the different bogus calls he's had or whatever.
Oh. All right. Well, let's hear.
Steven, yeah? Andrew, Robert, Leon is one of them.
Yeah, well, that's you tonight.
Yes, but you guys are still gullible. It's like each time I call
in. Oh, that's it?
Each time I call in.
Well,
it's like, It's like every call. I swear every call out there across America, it's fake. 90% of it's fake.
You think so?
Yes.
90%?
90% of it is mostly kids wanting to have fun on a Friday, Saturday. All throughout the week, they just want to have fun at night. So they call you guys up. I swear that's it. That's all I've been doing for the past 2 years.
Yeah, so we're not on Friday or Saturday.
Yeah. Sunday.
Oh, Sunday. All right.
Yeah, tonight. Yeah. Fake. It's all fake.
You think 90%, though?
95%.
Really?
I swear to God, it's all fake. Yes, I'd have five other friends all in the same city. They still call you guys. They're like, hey, I called the guys the other night. It was totally great, man. It was all fake. I was leading them on.
All right. I swear,
that's the schmeal right there.
All right. But here's the difference, Leon. I don't care if they're fake. I make $300,000 a year. How much you make calling the show?
Yeah, you're making money off a lie, though.
I don't care. What do you mean? What's a sitcom? You think Jack Tripper really lived with those two chicks in Three's Company?
What
do I care, you retard?
John Ritter?
Yes. All right, Leon. Hey. Keep calling up.
No, I won't.
No, please.
Not anymore.
I'm begging you.
No, jackass.
Call
no.
the show.
No, jackass.
Hey, Leon.
What?
What city you live in?
No, jackass.
What city you live in?
Jackass, whatever.
Hey, okay. Leon.
Whatever. Go back to your $3,000. See
three
if I
grand?
Can.
No, it's not $3,000. $300,000.
Yeah, $3,000 a freaking year. Try to inflate your salary right.
Hey, Leon.
Jackass.
Hey, Leon.
Jackass. Go scurry along now, fellow.
All right.
Scurry along, lad.
What was I? Hold on a second, Leon. I want to talk to Drew. I'll put you on hold, all right? All right, hang out?
Yeah.
All right. So I want to talk to you, all right?
Okay.
All right. All right, hold on. He didn't hang up, did he?
No, he's still there.
Leon?
Yeah, Jackass.
All right, hang on.
So he's having too much fun.
All right, that's fine. Loveline. Leon.
Yeah, whatever.
All right, hang on, all right?
Okay.
All right, we're going to take a little break. What city are you in?
Yeah, okay, buddy.
What city are you in?
What?
You in L.A.?
Yes, I'm in L.A.
Oh, good. All right, because let's see if I can hook up with Leon. To give him a good ass kicking. I got no problem with kicking Leon's ass. And if Leon, you want to come by the parking lot, I'll give you an ass kicking right here. I'll put a microphone out there and give him an ass kicking. I like that. I got no problem with that. All right, we'll take ourselves a little break. Leon, you hang on. And Kelly, we'll get to you and your eating disorder after this. Loveline. All right, let's check back in with Leon,
our
Loveline bogus caller. Leon?
Hey, media whore. How's it going?
All right, hang tight, all right?
Okay, Jackass.
All right. What?
Okay, I'm chilling here, Jackass, media whore.
Okay, which one's who?
Actually, you are the media whore.
Yeah.
And I am sort of a jackass for talking to you for such a long time.
Oh, come on, buddy. Don't be so hard on yourself.
What? You know what? I'd eat your ass for breakfast. You have your bodyguards out there protecting you. And, you know, you're a celebrity. You can't get your hands dirty.
Oh, no. Listen.
I would beat you down.
Oh, yeah?
Yes.
Okay, listen.
Oh, man.
I'll tell you what. You bring it on.
Right. Okay, and then you know what? It's going to be all across the tabloids.
No one cares what I do.
Talk show host, Loveline, blah, 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 whatever, gets beaten up by a longtime listener for being a jackass.
Well, listen, you name the place.
Okay, but I'm going to chill out here. I'm not through.
All right, hang on.
Okay.
All right, listen.
I'm not through.
All right, listen, hey, you come on over here if you want.
Right.
Come on over.
Right, and then when do I get to see your bodyguards, like creating a human shield around you?
Oh, no, no, listen. I will personally kick your ass if you come over here. I guarantee you that.
Do you have a black belt in kung fu? I think not.
I will guarantee I will personally kick your ass if you come here, and no one else will touch you except for me.
Can I get that in writing?
Yes, yes, come on down. I'll
right.
tell you.
Okay.
I'll put you on hold. I'll give you the address. You come on down.
Okay, certainly.
All right. All right, that'll be good times. David?
just picture who Leon is for a second.
I have no problem beating the crap out of him. I really don't.
You would just kill the guy.
I just want one good one. I won't hit him in the face. I just one to the body. Just want to just double him over. Loveline. All right, we'll talk to Brian. Oops, Brian? Brian?
Yes.
24?
24.
What's up?
Well, I had one question, but first of all, I wanted to know, what's your analyzation on about that guy that just called in so upset? You think it's a jealousy thing? What do you think that is?
Leon?
Yeah.
I don't know. What you asking, Brian?
I think he's just bored, really.
That's what it is?
Well, I'll give you...
They can put them on together if you want.
I can do that. What do I do? Yeah. Just press the lower one?
Yeah, just push it.
I tell you one thing. Leon is not getting any tail. Guys who do a lot of prank calling do not get sex. That's the prop. That's one of the things, and
so
I think
that's why he's so irritated with maybe you.
He could be angry about it. I don't know. You ask him yourself. Here he is.
The only reason I'm trying to irritate you is because you're so thin-skinned. The same thing with all the celebrities out there in the media world.
Do you want to be famous, bud?
What? Do I want to be famous? No, hell no, I don't want to be famous because I lose my identity if I do that, and then I lose. Then I get.
I don't get it.
What identity? The guy that's not getting laid.
Identity from humanity.
From humanity.
Anyway, that wasn't my question. My question was
right. Loveline.
Hey, Adam.
Wasn't that a Humble Pie song? Yeah.
Kick that dude's ass.
I'm gonna.
Yeah.
He won't. No, he's too big a pussy to come over here.
Yeah,
but listen, I'm not a liar. He'll come over here. I'll square up with him. No problems. No one else will get involved. Leon?
I'm trying to back out of it. I hear it in your
Leon?
Voice.
Leon?
That's why you're keeping me
hey,
on.
Hey, Leon, seriously. Hey, Leon.
It's getting too
weird. I know you'll never do it, but I'll give you the address of the place. You can come on over.
I am polishing my brass knuckles as we speak.
Bring them over.
Right, yeah.
Bring them over.
Okay, yeah.
Bring them over.
Okay.
You can use them if you want.
Right.
It won't bother me at all.
Easier said than done, right, Adam?
No, not. Listen.
It sounds good on the radio.
Hey, Leon.
Right?
Leon.
I mean, the audience really, like, eat if they feed off of it. Like
you,
hyenas.
You
but
come
no,
over
course,
and find out. You see,
back
you
it up
see.
With actual fist, no.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Right, right. Okay.
Oh, yes. I used to do it for a living. I had no problem doing it on you.
Yeah, but if you could do that, you wouldn't be able to because I'm too strong and fast.
Come on down and we'll find out. That's right. All I'm saying, brother.
I'm going to get kicked off the lot.
No, you will not. I'll let you right on in. I have no problem
Bye.
With that.
That's a lie. That's another lie.
All right, hang on, Leon. I'm serious. How far away are you? Because, you know, you only have like 40 minutes now.
By the way, yeah, you have to finish by midnight because Adam gets in his car and leaves.
You're going to need to get here right at 12 because I want to be in my car at 12:02. Okay?
Because right. You're going to go home to your duvet and your IKEA furniture.
Duvet? Oh, duvet. What is that?
It's a comforter.
Oh, no, that's a duvet.
Well, that's something I'm going to wrap you up with, and I'm kicking your ass.
That's a duvet. It's not a touvet. Yeah, I don't have one of those, but I got to get one of those. I do have the comforter, though. I enjoy that.
Touvet.
Stephanie, it's great that he made a point of that mispronouncing that word. Get home to your touvet. Loveline. Let's check Leon real fast here. Bogus caller, Leon.
Yeah, you're so smart.
Leon, you got to come down. You got to come down here, brother, because I'm going to be getting out of here.
Spell duvet if you're so smart.
Listen.
Spell duvet if you're so smart.
Listen, I'm not the one who mispronounced it. Now, come on down here.
Because I was frothing at the mouth.
Come on down here.
Right. Okay.
Seriously,
yeah.
What city are you calling from?
I'm calling from West Bank.
All right. You're not coming down here.
Yes, I am.
Come on, pussy. Come on down.
What the hell did you call?
Come on down, pussy. I'll give you the address. Listen, I'll go talk to you right off the air. Leon?
Yeah, what?
I'm going to talk to you off the air. I'll give you the address, okay?
Okay, jerk off.
All right, hang on. All right, we'll be back
I swear to Christ, I hope this guy comes down here. I'm going to love kicking his ass. All right, we'll be back in a minute.
Loveline.
It is Loveline. I'm Adam Carolla. That is Dr. Drew. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. I spoke to a caller, Leon, off the air and invited him down. He said he was calling from Palm Springs and said he was going to be in town next week. So I told him he can come down next week. And then he said he liked the show.
He's bisexual.
So I guess he's back on board.